Xingqiu is a character that has been neglected heavily by most of the global community due to a lot of misinformed tier lists, ranking him badly, as well as having a pretty unique set that most people did not understand at first. Meanwhile, he is most likely the best performing DPS support character in the game and is definitely worth of an S plus tier support role, as he is probably the character with the most burst damage and elemental combo enabling potential in the entire game. In this guide, I will focus on his burst DPS support build, since that is what he does best and how his kit is designed, though this character can also make a very decent main DPS if built appropriately. I will go over his kit and abilities and explain how to make them work for your team, as well as talk about his talents and which to level first. I will also talk about his constellations and note his different power spikes. Next, I will go over his stat priorities, his weapon choices, and his best artifact sets. Lastly, I will give some gameplay tips on how to use him and some of the greatest team comps options for him. The way Xingqiu works as a support is quite straightforward. His kit will allow you to summon water swords that will basically grant you a buff slash aura for a certain period of time. This will transfer to other characters when switching, which is why he is such a great support. That sword aura will then grant your characters with different bonuses such as damage reduction, healing, and burst damage. During his ult, those swords will attack with you and will enable tons of hydro-related elemental combos, as well as do incredibly high damage. His normal and charge attacks are quite standard, with pretty normal scaling. In a support build, you will not use these much, as you will focus on his skill and burst. His elemental skill is a very powerful hydro damage burst attack that will activate an aura of swords around you. Those rain swords will then help you resist interruptions as well as break one at a time when you take damage and reduce the damage you take. This scales with hydro damage as well and will give you up to 24% more damage reduction and is a very good defensive ability against big burst damage in the abyss, for example. This ability will also make your character wet and will summon 3 swords at first, as well as generate a lot of energy for your ult, so it should be used on cooldown for that purpose. Note that this does not stack with the ult, so try to use them both at different times for optimal uptime on the sword aura for the damage reduction effects. This ability lasts for 15 seconds and has 21 seconds of cooldown. His elemental burst, or ult, will summon your sword aura around you again, which will mirror the effect of the elemental skill completely for the full duration of the ult. Note that the swords will not break while the ult aura is active, so you will take reduced damage for the entire 15 seconds this ability lasts. Additionally, those swords will now attack with your active character's normal attacks. This adds a lot of damage as well as procs elemental water combos like crazy and is the entire reason why Xingqiu is so powerful as a support. This is the ability you want to use before going in for a burst phase on a boss or a strong monster, but just make sure that you are actually going to be doing normal attacks with the character that has the aura afterwards to maximize its potential, since it only triggers from normal attacks and not from charge attacks or skill use. For example, the Lux E ability does not make this trigger, but his normal attack does. His first passive talent will heal the current character by 6% of Xingqiu's max HP when one of the swords from the aura breaks or expires. This is a very nice amount of extra healing on top of the damage reduction. His second passive talent simply adds 20% hydro damage bonus, a very powerful buff to his damage. His other passive talent is actually one of the most amazing ones in the game, as it will let you get extra free talent upgrade material books when crafting them, which basically saves you a small amount of resin over time. When leveling up these talents, I would say prioritize the ult first and then the elemental skill. You do not need to level up the normal attack talent at all because you're using him as a support. As far as constellations goes, the first constellation is a very powerful one which increases the amount of sword his aura summons from 3 to 4, so this is very powerful for both his damage reduction, healing, and ult damage. The second constellation increases the duration of the ult by 3 seconds, which is already a big buff, as well as reduces the hydro resistance of enemies by 15%, which is very strong for some team comps, as well as for himself and his own damage. His fourth constellation makes it so that your elemental skill damage is increased by 50% while you're casting it when your ult is active. This is absolutely amazing, as you will be casting that ability on cooldown, especially when your ult is up, to regen more energy to have your ult up again. So this is a very, very welcome increase in damage. The sixth constellation is the most busted, amazing constellation that he has. It will make it so that your ult do insane damage every 3 proc, as well as generating energy every time the sword attacks with your character. This will make your ult cooldown regen even faster, as well as boost the damage from the ult like crazy. If you have this unlocked, you need to level up this character right away. As far as stat priority is concerned, energy recharge is the most important, as it allows you to have your ult up more often and generate more energy when using your E. 200 to 250 energy recharge is what you want to aim at the very least. Hydro damage is also a very important stat to have on him, as it boosts his ult damage, but also the damage reduction the swords give you. Crit rate and crit damage is also very good, as it will enhance the damage he does by a lot. You will want to make sure that you have energy recharge on the sands, hydro damage bonus on the goblet, and crit rate or crit damage on the circlet for maximum damage output. As far as secondary stats are concerned, energy recharge is obviously the highest priority. And then crit rate and crit damage is obviously very strong afterwards. And then you can go for either attack percentage, or elemental mastery for the last one. Now for the weapon choices, Skyward Blade is going to be one of the obvious best options, since it is a 5-star, which means that it has more base damage for higher scaling damage. It also has energy recharge and extra crit rate on the passive, which also provides a lot more damage output. Sacrificial Sword is probably the best 4-star option, and arguably might even be better than Skyward Blade due to the fact that it gives energy recharge, as well as an incredibly powerful effect that will sometimes let you reset the cooldown on his elemental skill. This allows him to basically fully charge his elemental burst every time you get a proc on the sword, which is obviously insanely valuable by giving you even more uptime on the ult. Pavonia's Sword is another great option, since it also has energy recharge, and the passive effect can really help with energy recharge as well. Even though energy recharge is optimal, other options could involve literally any of the weapons with crit rate and crit damage, such as a BP weapon or the Stargazer weapons, as well as some weapons with attack will also be decent, such as the flute for example, but because you are using him only for his support kit, you will almost never use his normal attack or stay on the character for very long, so a vast majority of these weapons and their effects would be completely wasted. For free-to-play options, Iron Sting is probably the best craftable option, but if you're using this, you will have to make sure that Genshin's sword effects are the ones triggering elemental combos, or the elemental mastery on the sword would be wasted. Sadly, when playing him as a support, especially for free-to-play, there are not going to be a lot of options that are going to be very good, and you will almost always want to have energy recharge on the sword no matter what. So the next best option, in my opinion, would be Skyrider Sword, the 3-star sword, simply because it has energy recharge and is quite good for him. Now, for the best artifact sets, 4-piece Noblesse Oblige is most likely the ultimate option for him. The 2-piece bonus does work with increasing his ult damage, as well as the 4-piece bonus can be applied constantly because you are using him as an energy recharge, which means you're going to have your ult up all the time, and the buff that it gives both applies to him and his damage, as well to the entire party, giving them more attack. It is the ultimate support set, and you must have one of these in every party. Other options would include 4-piece Exile, 4-piece Scholar, or 2-piece of each, and this will depend on what your party needs are, as they all provide different types of energy recharge mechanisms. Sadly, these items do not have 5-star versions, so in the late game, you will still have to replace them because you would be losing out on too much stat, but until then, any of these sets mixed together will perform very, very well no matter what. Other options could include a mix of 2-piece Noblesse with 2-piece Gladiator, or just mix and match depending on what you have available for you. Now for team comps and tips. Xingqiu's best potential comps are going to be when pairing him with a main DPS with fast attack speed, who also triggers a lot of elemental reaction. It is important to know that you want the character to normal attack as part of their kit. Now, because every time the sword attack with your character, they apply hydro, you also want to be easily able to proc the main DPS element on top of that to create combinations, not to go to waste. So you need some of these characters that will provide their own elements at the same time. Fischl is one of the MVPs here because she can simply drop the bird on the ground and then you can use Xingqiu's ult and use any other character's normal attack and the electric effect from the Bird Oz, as well as the water effect from the Xingqiu ult, will both proc together at the same time, no matter what DPS you're using, which will enable this to do insane damage with Electro Charge. He also pairs extremely well with Chongyun for a freeze shatter comp, as it is basically a must for that comp. If you are pairing him with characters such as Tartaglia or Mona, having the second constellation unlock will provide an incredible boost by reducing enemy hydro resistance, as well as provide hydro resonance, which will then increase the healing received. One of the best way to use water element is by utilizing the vaporize effect. Now, the vaporize effect triggers from fire and water mixed together. If a fire ability triggers vaporize, it will do 150% damage, while if a hydro ability triggers vaporize, it will do 200% damage. The great thing about him is that there is almost no character that would not benefit from having him in the team, and it is one of the reasons why he is so crazy powerful. He enables freeze and shatter with cryo character, electro charge with electro character, vaporize with power characters, and crystallize even with geo character. He can also work with certain animal characters, but again, only the ones who would use their normal attacks, such as Jean. I hope this guide was useful to you guys. Xingqiu is by far one of the best characters to use in any party. The fact that he adds resistance to interruption, as well as reducing the damage taken while his swords are active, on top of doing crazy amount of damage and proccing a mental combo, makes him an amazing support. He is both defensive and offensive at the same time. He will save your life in the abyss many times without you realizing it, as well as he will make it so that mobs die twice as fast as you expected them to die. You must and should use this character, especially if you have any constellation on him. He is going to have a place in almost any party in the game and will make your life easier no matter what. Make sure to stay tuned for our upcoming character guides for characters such as Sucrose, Diluc, and Chongyun, as well as updated guides on Razor, Mona, Chi-Chi, and Zhongli when he comes out. Feel free to check out any of our other character guides in the description or in the comment section below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. See you guys on the next.